This is a quick video on combining the right-hand rules. This is a pretty simple concept. I'm going to show you what I mean. Let's say that you have a fixed wire, that means it can't move, and it's carrying a current pointing straight down like this. Using the curl right-hand rule, I can see that on the left of the wire, the magnetic field is going to be going into the page, while on the right of the wire, the magnetic field is coming out of the page like this. Now let's imagine that I take a second wire, and this time this wire is movable. So this wire can be moved back and forth like this. And I'm going to imagine that the current is also pointing straight down. So you'll notice that because of the magnetic field created by that first wire, that second wire is now in a situation where it's a current-carrying wire in a perpendicular magnetic field. So if I use the corner right-hand rule on that wire, I find that there's a force pulling that other wire toward the fixed wire, and it's being created by the magnetic field that that first wire is creating. So if you have two wires with strong currents that are both pointing in the same direction, they will actually attract each other. And you can see that if we flipped the direction of the current, using the right-hand rule, the force will now point in the opposite direction and the wires will be repelled from each other. So this is a pretty simple concept. It's basically just saying, okay, there's a magnetic field created by this first wire. I know how to find that direction using the curl right-hand rule. A second wire experiences that magnetic field and I know how it will respond using the corner right-hand rule. So that's what I mean by combining two right-hand rules together to predict motion.